Aaron Sicotte is the new principal at Needham High School. He's well known in the school because he previously served as assistant principal. We wanted to give the Needham community the chance to get to know the new principal, so we spoke with him about his background, his goals for the school, and challenges he'll face this year.
I taught for 10 years. My first five were in Framingham, right up the road a little ways, and then we moved out to New York to be near my wife's family, so I taught for another 5 years in a town called Guilderland, New York, outside of Albany. And I, during that time, I started to get a little bit more interest in having an impact on students' experiences on a broader level. So I started to get involved in larger school initiatives and school committees, and really appreciated the impact that I could have beyond just the impact I was having with my specific set of students. That drew me into an administrative certification program in New York, and I had the opportunity to go through a great program and became an assistant principal out in the school that I was in outside of Albany. Had a great experience out there, loved the school, loved the people I got to work with and the students. The whole time though, my wife and I were really hoping to get back to Massachusetts. So we were excited when we really decided this was what we wanted to do. Opportunity presented itself here in Needham. I was thrilled to come and realize that as much as I enjoyed my school in New York, this is an unbelievable place to be. I really want to make sure I'm spending a lot of time listening and learning and continuing to get a better sense of the students, of the people, of the goals of the community and the people within the community, even if they're not directly connected to the schools. So that's really my number one priority this year. I also think that we do a great job of preparing our students exceptionally well for life after high school. And we make their high school experience, I think, a really positive one. I think that we can emphasize the human side even more, and I think that's something that I'd like to see us balance that preparation and high expectations for academics with the recognition that we are dealing with individual people who are really growing a lot in these 4 years, and really incumbent upon us to meet them where they are and make sure that we're supporting them through that process in a really positive and supportive and exciting way. We are in a unique position. We have a fairly new building, and we really appreciate and benefit from the support that the town put into that, you know, over 10 years ago now. And yet, despite that recent investment, we are overcrowded. The building was originally designed for 1,450 students. We have just shy of 1,700 this coming year, and in a year or so, we're gonna hit about 1,750 and plateau there for quite a few years, over a decade. So it's not a short blip. It's not something that we need to just kind of get through. It's something that the high school has been dealing with for a number of years already and will only get more crowded. We have repurposed essentially every space that we possibly could. There were in the original design a number of spaces dedicated to curriculum work room for teachers or for resources. Those have all long since turned into classroom space. And I think we very consciously and thoughtfully made sure that despite how crowded we're getting, the impact on the students was as small as it possibly could be. And really, it was the adults in the building that felt that pinch. Unfortunately, we're getting to a point where we don't have really any more options beyond what we've already done. And I think the students' experience will start to be impacted. We've been very appreciative. The town has recently helped to expand our cafeteria space. We've been very tight on fire code with some of our lunches over the last few years, and now we will comfortably be able to accommodate all of our students in the lunchroom. And beyond space, we're, I think, uniquely positioned to not be a building or a district that has tremendous pressing challenges ahead of us. It's not as though there are immediate needs we need to address, which gives us opportunities to address needs that may not be so readily apparent or talked about so openly. One area that we're really prioritizing and have been for a number of years now is really increasing the cultural proficiency of our staff and students. And what that really means is enhancing the experience that all of us have in the building, especially students and staff coming from traditionally marginalized groups. So it creates an environment where everybody is welcomed, regardless of their background, regardless of their experience. Everybody is treated respectfully, and we all want to do that. Yet we live in a society that has some historically embedded racism, and we are openly talking about that here at the high school and trying to make it conscious so that we can consciously overcome some of those unconscious behaviors and attitudes that we have. This is not work that is being done in this way in other communities or schools. And we're proud and excited that we recognize this need and are doing everything we can to shape each one of our students and our staff's thinkings to make sure that they are really strong, positive contributors to not just this community, but to every community they're part of going forward.